Hello children, welcome back. So this is our second session of chapter number 2, linear equations in one variable. So children, in the last session you have learnt what do you mean by linear equations in one variable. You have also solved sums or problems based on that. You have also seen few examples of word problems, how to create an equation and then how to solve it. So in this session today we are again going to deal with the word problems. So let us start word problems from exercise 2.2. So let us begin with today's session, children. So this is our next, that is the first sum. If you subtract 1 upon 2, that is half, from a number and multiply the result by half, that is 1 upon 2, you get 1 upon 8. What is the number? So let us first once again read the question, and step wise let us try to form an equation. So here, if you subtract 1 upon 2 from a number, now this a number is unknown. We don't know what is the number. So let us begin from here only. Let the number be x. You can take any variable, children. Here we have taken x. You can take y, z, whatever you wish. So let the number be x. Now you have to subtract 1 upon 2 from this x. So let us write it as x minus 1 upon 2. And multiply the result, whatever result you get, multiply that by again 1 upon 2. So if I take a number x and subtract 1 upon 2 from it, whatever result I get, I'm going to multiply again 1 upon 2 to that result. And when we do all this, we get 1 upon 8. So here is our equation we have created. So once you get the equation, then it will be very easy to solve further, and then you can find the value of the unknown thing, that is the variable. So here you can see it is 1 upon 2 into x minus 1 upon 2 equal to 1 upon 8. So this is the equation what we got. Now let us further solve it. Now here, one by one, all the terms except the variable, what all the constants are there with the variable, we are going to shift it to the other side. So 1 upon 2, if I go this side, it will be again multiplied by this 2 in the denominator, will go to the numerator. So now this 1 upon 2, I am shifting it to the right hand side. It will become 2 upon 1, that is nothing but 2. So it will be in the right side, it will be 1 upon 8, that is already there, multiplied by 2. That is, this 1 upon 2 shifted to the right hand side. Now here, left hand side, it is x minus 1 upon 2 remaining. And this side, 1 upon 8 multiplied by 2 will be 2. 4 is 8, so it is 1 upon 4 remaining, and here again x minus 1 by 2 as it is. Now here, along with the x, negative 1 upon 2 is there. When we shift it to the other side, it becomes plus 1 upon 2. So 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 2 is nothing but 3 upon 4. How to solve the fractions? We have already learned, children. First bring the denominator same, that is take the LCM, and then you can add the numerators. So hence we get the x value as, we get the x value as 3 upon 4. Hence the number which we have to find out is 3 upon 4. So I hope you understood this, children. Let us proceed with the next word problem. So the basic thing is, you have to first form the equation. Once you get the equation, then further you can find the value of the unknown thing. Now let us see, there is one more example here. Base of an isosceles triangle. Now isosceles triangle is two sides are equal, any two sides. So now let us see, isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeters. So base is, now you can see here we have drawn a triangle and two sides are equal. So let us take that x as a length, and this length, that is base length, is 4 upon 3 centimeters. The perimeter of the triangle is 4 2 upon 15. Perimeter, we know children, when we add all the three sides, it is equal to the perimeter. So here now, first thing is, let us take perimeter equal to 4 2 upon 15. Now this 4 2 upon 15 is mixed fraction. Let us first convert it into an improper fraction. How to do the conversion, you know very well. The whole number multiplied by denominator, whatever you get the product, add the numerator. So here 4 into 15 plus 2 divided by 15 will be equal to 62 upon 15. So the perimeter is now 62 upon 15. So here now perimeter equal to sum of all the sides, that is 62 upon, now substituting the value of the perimeter here will be 62 upon 15 will be equal to AB plus AC plus BC, that is X plus X plus 4 upon 3. So now X plus X becomes 2X and plus 4 by 3 as it is, and this side is 62 upon 15. Now let us shift this 4 by 3 to the other side. So 2x will remain to the one side, and 62 upon 15 minus 4 by 3 plus 4 by 3 shifted to the other side, it becomes negative 4 by 3. Now 2x equal to, again the fraction, first take the LCM and then solve it. So we get, after taking the LCM, we get the value 2x equal to 42 upon 15. Now again along with the x there is a value. So here 2x, 2 will be shifted to the other side, it becomes 1 upon 2. So x will be equal to 42 upon 15 and multiplied by 1 upon 2, that is x will be equal to, multiplication no need to take the LCM, numerator to numerator we multiply, denominator to denominator, if you are able to cancel you can cancel. So 42 divided by 2 we get 21 divided by 15, and 21 divided by 15 will be equal to again 7 upon 5, solving further, and 7 upon 5 again converted to the mixed fraction, we get 1 2 upon 5. So this x is the value which we have taken for the sides of the triangle, two sides because it is an isosceles, equal sides are. So length of the remaining two sides you can write as 1 2 upon 5 centimeters. So that's it children, let us move further with the next one. Yeah, so here is one another example. Sum of two numbers is 95. Now which two numbers, we don't know. So let us take first number be x. If one exceeds the other by 15, so exceeds the other by 15 means, exceeds means plus 15. So let us take the second number as x plus 15. Find the numbers. So here we know now sum of the two numbers we got it, that is one is x and the other is x plus 15, and they said sum of two numbers is 95. So can I write x plus 15 equal to 95? Yes, so this is our equation, that is x plus 15 equal to 95. X plus x you will get 2x, 2x plus 15 equal to 95. Now one by one, whatever constants are available with the variable, you have to shift it to the other side to find the value of the variable. So here now 15 plus 15, when you shift it to the other side, it becomes minus 15. So 95 minus 15, you will get 80. And this side is 2x equal to 80. Again now 2, if you shift it this side, the right hand side, you will get x equal to 80 upon 2. You can see here x equal to 80 upon 2, which is nothing but x equals to 40. So now you have to find the two numbers. So first number it was x, where you can write first number equal to x, which is equal to 40. We know that. Now second number we have taken that it exceeds 15, so x plus 15. So substitute the value of x here. Now 40 plus 15 equal to 55. So these are the two numbers. One is 40 and the other one is 55. So I hope you understood, children, this. Let us proceed with the next one. So basically the first main thing about the word sums is forming an equation. Once you form a linear equation, then you know how to solve the linear equations. That is transporting the constants to the other side and first finding the value of the variable and then the related values, whichever you are asked to find out. So let us proceed, children. Yeah. Now three consecutive integers add up to 51. Consecutive means continuous the numbers which are in. So first let us take the first integer as x. Second integer will be x plus 1 and third integer will be x plus 2. If they asked 4, the next one will be x plus 4 and so on. So these are the consecutive numbers, right? So they all add up to, these three consecutive numbers add up to 51. So we can write x plus 1 plus x plus 2 equal to 51. So you can see here it is x plus 1 plus x plus 2 equal to 51. So let us now add up this all. So this x plus 1 plus 2 equal to 51. 1 plus 2 becomes 3 and x plus x becomes 3x. So 3x plus 3 equal to 51. Now one by one shift all the constant that is transporting to the other side. Now if I transport this positive 3 to other side, you can see here this positive 3, if I transport this side, it becomes negative 3. So 51 minus 3 and the left hand side will be 3x. That is, here you can see now 3x equal to 48. Now again this 3 is in multiplication form. When it gets transported to the other side, it comes in division. So x will be again equal to 48 upon 3. Now x is equal to 16. Now we got our value of the variable, that is x equal to 16. So they have asked to find the three consecutive numbers. So 1 is 16. The second number will be 16 plus 1, that is 17. And the third number will be 17. What we got, x, that is 16 plus 2, that is 18. So the three consecutive numbers are 16, 17 and 18. I hope you all are getting, children. Yeah. So here is the another one. Yeah. So this is the next one. Three consecutive integers. Again consecutive. Next to next numbers. We have to take are such that when they are taken in increasing order and multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively, they add up to 74. Find these numbers. So let us begin, children. So let us first take the first integer be x. Now what will be the next? Yes, x plus 1. What will be the next one? Yes, x plus 2. The next will be x plus 3, x plus 4 and so on. These are the consecutive integers. So let us first take integer be x. So here we have to take three consecutive integers. So second will be x plus 1, third will be x plus 2. Now they are saying whenever you are taking the next number, first is multiplied by 2, second integer is multiplied by 3 and the third integer is multiplied by 4 respectively. So let us multiply our first number is multiplied by 2. So our here first number we have taken as x multiplied by 2 will be 2x. Now second number is multiplied by 3. Our second number is x plus 1 multiplied by 3. So 3 into bracket x plus 1. Now the third number is multiplied by 4. Here it will be 4 into bracket x plus 2. So these are our numbers, consecutive numbers multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively. Now he is saying that they all add up to 74. So let us see now. Yeah. So let us add up. The first number is 2x plus the second number is 3 into x plus 1 plus 4 into x plus 2 is all adding up to, that is equal to 74. So now let us solve further. Let us open the bracket. 3 multiplied by x will be 3x and plus 3 into 1 will be 3. Similarly, 4 into x will be 4x plus 4 into 2 will be plus 8. So now we have opened our brackets here. Now let us further solve. Now here it is 2x plus 3x plus 4x, total 9x, and 3 plus 8 will be plus 11 equal to 74 as it is. Now this is our equation. You can see it is 9x plus 11 equal to 74, linear equation. Now one by one, all the constants present with the variable, you have to shift it, transport it to the other side. So here now we are first going to transport positive 11 to the other side, which becomes negative 11, that is 74 minus 11. So here 9x will be equal to 63. So x will be equal to, again transporting 9 to the other side, will be 63 upon 9, which is equal to x equal to 7. Once you get the value of x, let us find the three consecutive numbers. First is equal to x, that is equal to 7. Second number will be x plus 1, which is 7 plus 1, 8. Third number is x plus 2, which is equal to 7 plus 2 equal to 9. So the three consecutive numbers are 7, 8 and 9. So I hope you understood, children. Let us see one more, the next example. Yeah. So the ages of Rahul and Harun are in the ratio 5 is to 7. So here let us take the age of Rahul as 5x and age of Harun as 7x. 4 years later, now this 4 years later it is talking, so let us assume that these are the present ages of Rahul and Harun. So 4 years later, the sum of their ages will be 56 years. 4 years later means we have to add 4 more years, right? So after 4 years, age of Rahul will be 5x plus 4. 5x is present age, add 4 more, that is 5x plus 4 years. And Harun age will be 7x plus 4 years. And when we add this to the age of Harun and the age of Rahul, we get 56 years. So let us see, let us add up. So here we get 5x plus 4 plus 7x plus 4 equal to 56. Let us open the bracket. 5x and 7x becomes 12x. 5x plus 7x becomes 12x. And 4 plus 4 becomes 8, which is equal to again 56 as it is. So now we got our equation 12x plus 8 equal to 56. Further, now you know what is to be done. Whatever constants are present with the variable, transport it to the other side of the variable. So let us start. Positive 8 plus 8, when we transport it to the other side, it becomes minus 8. That is 56 minus 8, we get 48. So again here 12 is present with the variable. It is in multiplication. Transport it to the other side, it is in coming in division. So x will be equal to 48 upon 12, and which is nothing but x equal to 4. Now here we got x equal to 4. We have to find the present age of Rahul is 5x. So 5 into, substitute the value of x, that is 4. So here you can see 5 into 4 will be equal to 20 years. So present age of Rahul is 20 years. And present age of Harun will be 7x, that is 7 into 4 equal to 28 years. That's it, children. I hope now you people are getting how to solve the word problems. So the main thing is to create a equation in one variable, and then one by one transport the variable constants which are present with the variable to the other side and find the value of the variable. And once you get find the value of the variable, then later on you can find whatever is asked in the question. So one more example is here. Let us proceed with that. Okay, now the number of boys and girls in a class are in the ratio 7:5. So here you can see, let us assume number of boys is 7x and number of girls is 5x. So here I have taken like the number of boys in the class is 7x and number of girls in the class is 5x. The number of boys is 8 more than the number of girls. So number of boys, you can see here, number of boys is equal to number of girls plus 8. That is, I can write here 7x equal to, you can see here, 7x equal to 5x plus 8. Now here if you see, children, both the side variable is present. So when such condition comes, first you have to bring all the variables to one side. So let us see. So here it is, the 5x has been transported to the left hand side. So positive 5x becomes negative 5x. So here we get 7x minus 5x equal to 8. And 7x minus 5x is nothing but 2x. 2x equal to 8. So x equals to 4. That is, 2 is transported this side. It becomes 8 divided by 2. So it is x equal to 4. Therefore, number of boys. Now, once you get the value of the variable, find out the number of boys and girls. We have assumed number of boys is 7x. That is, 7 into 4 will be 28. And number of girls, 5x. 5 into 4 will be 20. So the total class strength of number of boys plus number of girls is equal to 28 plus 20, that is 48 students. So this is very important, children. Few times it happens that you just find the number of boys, number of girls, and you, so don't do that. Read the question properly and understand what is asked. So they have asked total class strength, so we have to add the strength of boys and girls here. So be careful, read the question properly and find the answer. So let us move further. Okay, so these are few home assignments which I am giving you. So I hope everybody will solve this. So the first sum is, yeah, two numbers are in the ratio 5:3. 5:3, everybody knows two numbers means, let the first number be 5x and let the second number be 3x. If they differ by 18, that is, the difference between the two numbers is 18, means 5x minus 3x equals to 18. Easy, 5x minus 3x equal to 18. Once you get, now you can find the number, that is 5x minus 3x will be again 2x, 2x equal to 18, transport the 2, whatever value you get, find out. And later on, substitute the value of x in 5x and 3x and get the two numbers. I hope this is easy, children, for you. So everybody will solve that, right? The next one is the sum of 3 consecutive multiples of 8. Now here they have said consecutive multiples of 8. So let us assume that the first number is x. So next number will be x plus 8, because multiple of 8 it is. And the third number will be x plus 8 plus 8, that is x plus 16. So like that way you have to take the multiples of 8. So once you get these three numbers, they are the sum is 888. So you can write x plus x plus 8 plus x plus 16 is equal to 888. So x plus x will be 3x. And 8 plus 16 will be 24. So 3x plus 24 equal to 808 is your equation. Now one by one transport the constant present with the variable to the other side and find the value of the x. And later on substitute the value of x in the whatever we have assumed the numbers and find the three consecutive numbers. That's it. So I hope today's session was clear. I hope you understood how to solve the word problems, word sums. And these two assignments, children, please try. If you will try by your own, you will solve. The concept will be more clear. So that's it. Keep studying, children. Keep doing your assignments on time. Thank you for today. Bye-bye.